Hello folks, welcome to bisptrainings.com. My name is Amit and today I'm going to show you how to create custom defined grouping in Microsoft SSAS. It's a part of my advanced data modeling technique. It's a pretty small session in which we will be understanding how would you use a custom defined case statement in your data source view. So this is a requirement. My requirement is something like this. I have a sales territory as one of my dimension, which talk about sales by different territory, region and country. In addition to the region, territory, country and group, my business also like to identify the market type. They need this market type member in order to calculate a discounting policy. The discounting policy depends upon the type of market. The logical classification of market type is, which I've written in a case statement, the business wanted to see market in three category: growing market, big market and small market. The growing market, if any sales territory is either northwest or southeast, it is considered to be a growing market. If sales territory is southwest, it is considered to be a big market. If it is Canada or Germany, it is a small market. Any other territory fall outside these three groups are considered to be a small market. Because this column does not exist in my underlying table, I'll be stitching this column, creating this column in named query. This is called custom defined group over here. Let's see how to do this. So I'll go to my named query. I'll go to my data source view before I starting a queue. As we discussed a couple of times, then one should try to manipulate all data related concern in a data source view itself. I create a new named query, or I could add a computed column over here. I'll edit this. I can replace this with my named query, which I already in the previous example, and I added my query over here. You can convert any source into named query. Right click and just convert to a named query, which I already did in this example because I want to customize a query expression. Right click and go to edit query name, edit named query, and here is the SQL query expression. You can write your own query expression over here. I'll be using sales territory to write a custom defined expression. My expression like this, sales statement. Sales territory is in between this and this. So let's write. I can manually type the expression over here. Sales territory region. I'll be using it for my. So I'll take sales territory region and write a case statement for the same. I'll open and close parenthesis. Case when my sales territory is one of them. This is my requirement. If sales territory is northeast, sales territory, when sales territory region is northeast, I put in single quotes, or southwest, or southwest, it is considered to be a growing market. I just copy this expression, paste over here, southwest. I continue to do the same thing for other member as well. In order to save time, I already done some of this iteration. If this is a situation, then I like to specify this is a growing market. In the same fashion, I continue to do the same thing for other member as well, which I already did in this example. So I write multiple case statement when sales territory is this, then specify is southwest, then specify big market. And you continue to do the same thing, and eventually you end this with end statement. I'll give an alias name as market type. So though this column does not exist, but still I manipulate this column to my source as if it's coming from my data source, and it is all is going to be manipulated in your source query itself. Done. That's it. Click on OK. You got a new column called market type. Right click and export the data. Now I can see my sales territory depends upon the type of market rather than by sales territory name. Further, I'm going to group them up depends upon growing market or big market and apply my discounting policy. So this is such a small topic. We'll continue to talk about how to implement advanced discounting policy on top of this computed column. Thanks for watching this video, and should you have more query, please feel free to visit our site www.bsptrainings.com. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel to access more videos. Thank you.